How do I interpret teams, according to Ian Rappaport, my colleague at the NFL Media Group? How do I interpret his report that teams are calling the Seahawks to kick the tires on Russell Wilson? Why would a team call another for their clear franchise face? Why would they do that, Joe?
Well, I would call. What do you got to lose? And he has expressed verbally at least a little frustration, and I'd love to know kind of the question you asked me about Deshaun Watson. Is this some – I'm a huge Russell Wilson fan. He's looked great, and I think if he's in a more complex and more creative offense, he'd look even better. So on the long shot that there's something that answers that question, what would it actually be that could make it worth your while that you'd consider moving him? I actually make that call. I know the odds are it's over in 60 seconds. I got nowhere. They either hung up on me or dismissed me as a fool. But I think he's such a good player and seemingly has a number of years left that I would actually make that call myself. And so what do you get to lose call, in my opinion, for, I think, a really, really tough player?
I guess it's the Gretzky phrase, you miss 100% of the shots you don't take. But exactly. But is there like a rumor mill amongst management where you hear, you know, the whispers that he's not happy or something like that? I mean, why wouldn't I call the Bucks to see if the, you know, Brady's available? You know what I mean? Like, it doesn't, you know.
Yes is the first part. There is a rumor mill. It's often wrong, so you don't put too much weight in it. But he also, I saw some comments he made in a radio interview. It seemed to be, you know, more about having more input and maybe some frustrations of the offensive line had never really been a priority with the organization. But that's enough for me to just check if there's more going on behind the scenes than, you know, that public comment. And by the way, if Brady would make comments or any other of those top quarterbacks, and I didn't have a top quarterback that made it sound like there was a possibility, that's how the Eagles acquired Jason Peters. He was having a holdout in Buffalo. Didn't seem very tense. It just seemed like kind of a normal, probably short-term holdout. We said, hey, what the heck? Let's call them and just make sure there isn't more under the surface. More upsetness than was getting reported. And lo and behold, they said, well, what would you give us? And then we got serious and had a back and forth and ended up trading a late one and a four for a Hall of Fame left tackle. So you never know. And when you hear there's a little bit that is tipping above the water, you're not sure how much is below the water. It's worth checking.
So you make a phone call to Green Bay the day after Aaron Rodgers had his post-game comments and losing the NFC Championship game, basically, is what
you're
saying.
Yeah, I may give it 48 hours just to make sure that there's something there. But yes, I do. And I think teams did.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.